Hey guys, just a quick message before this video starts. Just want to give a quick shout out to the Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. It is a book absolutely rammed with information regarding anything HGV related. Promise you, you won't regret it. Link is in the description down below if you are interested. The Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. Anyway, enjoy the video. I've been speaking to Kev T, who's around that area, and he said, have fun, Luke. He said, have your cameras rolling, Luke. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Luke. Thanks for watching. I do appreciate it. How are you? How are you? I'm particularly happy this morning. I'm not entirely sure why. Actually, it's not even morning. It's afternoon. I'm going to start off by saying what I've already done today, and then I get on with what this video is going to be about. So today, I drove from Swindon all the way up to Fleetwood near Blackpool. Delivered 20 bags there, or was it 30? 30 bags there. No, it was 20. It was 20 bags. It was 15 and 5, I remember now. And then from Fleetwood, I drove back down to Preston and I delivered 12 pallets. I am now empty and we are heading towards Pollington. Calcay is where we're going to in Pollington, where we're going to get loaded with God knows what. I'm going to assume pallets of like compost and stuff, because we have got three drops to three separate garden centres, and that is what you're going to see in this video. Now, it's probably going to be delivered tomorrow, not today, although I might try and get one off today, we'll see. But either way, this video is going to be over a couple of days, so it will be dark, and then it will be light again. So hopefully you enjoy. But we're only about 5 miles away now from Pollington. We're going to get loaded with a full load of pallets, I assume. We're going to have to strap them all up, and then make our way to the three drops. We're going to Dobby's Garden Centre in Gloucester, and then Dobby's Garden Centre in Cirencester, which is actually literally 5 minutes away from my yard. And then we're going to Castle Gardens in Sherborne, which is quite far south. So that's what we're doing today. If we can get the first one off, the Gloucester one, very unlikely, but if we can, then obviously the next drop, Cirencester, which is 5 minutes away from the yard, I can go home tonight. But I don't think we're going to get it off. So I'm fully prepared for a night out. I am most Mondays, to be fair. Normally a Monday is a night out. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to go get loaded now, and then we're going to leave. We're going to put in the postcode to the first destination, see what our ETA is, and then give them a call and just ask the question. Would you take a delivery at 6 o'clock or whatever? Because it probably will be around that time, if not later. I think they close at 7, so we never know. They might stop taking deliveries at 4 o'clock. But if you don't ask, you don't get, do you? Right, we're nearly there. Let's go get loaded then. Let's go get these pallets on. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so we're just getting loaded now. Forklift is getting us loaded. They look like sort of like black pallets, really. I don't know if you can quite see over there. That's the forklift there. He's picking up these pallets. They're not very tall pallets at all. What I will do in a minute is I'll put in the postcode for the place we're going to and just see how long it takes to get there. It's 140 miles away for starters. it's not a quick journey to get back down. Just calculating the route now. I reckon it's a good sort of 3.5 hour drive, I reckon. We'll have to get a break in as well before we go down there. 176 miles, 3.5 hour drive, yeah. So, if we left now, we'd get there for 5 o'clock. We're probably gonna be at least another hour before we leave here, I expect, so. We're probably talking 6 o'clock. And according to Google, they close at 7, so. Yeah, there's a chance. the chance they may offload me tonight. Who knows? Who knows? Like I said, we need to get a break in as well, so if they take 45 minutes loading me here, then happy days. But if not, then we are gonna have to stop for half an hour break anyway, so we won't make it then before they shut, I don't think. We will see. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, here's the situation. We are now fully loaded. Hang on a sec. Yeah, we're fully loaded. Supposed to be going to Gloucester first, but they've messed up somehow, and it's actually Thornbury in Gloucestershire. So my load's around the wrong way. The good news is I've got to go siren sister first, which is around the corner from the yard. So if I got enough drive time, I'm going straight back to the yard tonight. / delivering today, but I need to do some calculations. Ooh. Yeah, no, I haven't got enough time to even get back to the yard tonight, I don't think. So I'm on a 7 hours, 11 minutes of driving. So 9 would put that up to 20, which would then be 40, which would be 8, 1, or 2:49. So I've only got an hour and 49 minutes of drive time left, or 2 hours 49 if I go into a 10. And I'm like over 3 hours away from the yard, so yep, won't be going home tonight, or won't have enough time. So it's just a case of trying to find out what time they can take delivery in the morning at Cirencester. I also started at 20 past four this morning, 5, 6, 7, so I can work until 19:20, but I've run out of driving time by then. I've done a lot of driving today already. Didn't even realise I'd done that much. Never mind. So, the next challenge now is to try and find somewhere to park. Because it's mostly motorway all the way down there. But I think I'm going to need to have secure parking. Because they could take some stuff off the back of this lorry if they wanted to. Thieves, that is. Okay. Engine on. Let's put this there, and you can do a going on charge as well. Okay, let's get crack-a-lackin' into drive. Let's go. That sun is bright. Yeah, so we're fully loaded. Slight change of plan. We are going to Cirencester first because the Gloucester run that we're supposedly doing turns out is actually a Thornbury in Gloucestershire. Cirencester is in Gloucestershire as well, but the paperwork says Thornbury Gloucester. So when I said to the bloke in the order I wanted it loaded, he put Gloucester in the on the back. But it's actually Thornbury, which means it's near Bristol. Which means Cirencester is now closest, and it's in the middle of the load of the trailer. So I gotta go Cirencester first because obviously it's a waste of fuel, and I gotta get them to move some pallets just to get to their 4 pallets. But if they want it, that's what they're gonna have to do. So tough. So yeah, tomorrow, because I'm not gonna have enough time to do it today, because I've just done a printout. I've done 7 hours and 10 minutes of driving today already. It's a lot. I've done a lot more driving than I thought. So I've only got an hour and 45 minutes. Give or take, just a slightly more than that, an hour and 49 to be precise, to find somewhere to park up, or 2 hours 49 if I go into a 10-hour drive, which I could do because I'm only working 4 days this week because I'm off Friday because I'm getting married. Well, I say I'm getting married, I'm supposed to be getting married, but obviously Boris Johnson has stopped all weddings from happening. So on the day I'm supposed to get married, and the week I'm supposed to be on my honeymoon, I'm still taking off. And hopefully when I get back, hopefully, it might change it, but when I get back from my holiday, there might be something waiting for me. That's all I'm saying. There might not, it might change. But yeah, all I know now is that we've got an hour and 45 minutes of drive time left, and we need to go find somewhere to park up. So I'm gonna make some phone calls and try and find out the best place to park. See you in a bit. Okay, so we've had a little thing. We've had a few phone calls, and I'm going to stop at Lincoln Farm. It's just south of Birmingham. That's pretty much the furthest I can get as well, actually. I reckon I'll be on about 9.5 hours drive time by the time I get there. I've stopped at Lincoln Farm a few times. It's on Snap. Costs 20 quid to park there for the night. But you get a hot meal as well. You've got to pay, obviously, for the hot meal. Might even have a beer. Who knows? But yeah, we're going to stop at Pollington. And then in the morning, I think it's going to be about an hour and a half drive down to Cirencester for the first delivery. Got to be there for 7 o'clock. So that's what we would do. So yeah, just going to crack on now, get to Lincoln Farm. Hopefully we'll be there in about an hour and 50 minutes, about 90 miles away from where we are now. Traffic like this, though, is not going to help. But hopefully we'll be parked up by 5 o'clock tonight, which isn't too bad, being parked up by 5. It's actually quite an early finish, really. It's a normal finish, 5 o'clock. It's like a 9 till 5 job, except I started at 4 o'clock this morning. Half 4-ish. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, it is now 25 minutes past 5. It is dark, and we're just about to pull up for the night in Lincoln Farm. Got half a mile to go, then we can turn right. I'm not quite sure what time we need to leave in the morning. I think it's going to be about 5:30, but I'll double check very momentarily once we get in there, and we'll let the guys know. But yeah, I'm looking forward to actually having a hot meal today. I'm really hungry. Right, we need to actually get over. So yeah, we're, according to the sat nav, we're 77 miles away from where we need to be. It's going to take about an hour and 45 to get there. I think we want to, it's a bit squeaky, I think we want to be leaving about 5:30 the latest, 5:30. We are fully loaded. I've come in here before like 7:30, 8 o'clock at night, and it's still not been rammed, so hopefully there's plenty of space. I don't know where anyone is. Normally there's a bloke telling you where to park.
Go next to Witt. It's a blue trailer.
Yeah, next to one on the left hand side, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, right, mate. Witt. Blue trailer. On the left hand side. Where is Witt? Oh, there he is. I see him. Oh. Bumpy road. There is Whitlet on the right hand side. He said park on the left. This is our parking for the night. Happy days. Whew. Parked up. We are done. Done. What do I need to do? Paperwork. That's what I need to do. Need to clock off. What time is it? 5:30. Yeah. 4:30. Yeah, so I'll get I'm going to get a 12-hour break in. Just under a 12-hour break. So that's good. Turn the engine off. Lights off. Right, ejecto. 17:30. Reload. Yeah, so we're just gonna need to do a printout now just to find out how many hours we've driven today. I'm like 99% sure we've gone over 9 hours, definitely. We've gone into a 10-hour drive. But I wanna know exactly how much. I reckon it's gonna be like 9:40 or something. Just put the mileage in. Oh, we reached 1 million miles. 1 million kilometres. So the display's reset back to zero, so now we're on 2657. So I just put 2657 265. Okay, moment of truth. 9:44. So that is a 10-hour drive. So we've only got one more 10-hour drive to use up this week. Right, we now need to go and pay for fuel. We now need to go and pay for parking, and get some hot food, and then I'm going to come back in here and eat my hot food and watch some TV on my tablet. Here it is. We are charged? No, we're not charged. Bloody hell. We are not charged. So let's put that on now while we're going to go get some food. And that'll charge up nice and quick. There we go, 6%. Good morning. It is now morning. And it's 25 past 5. Just about getting a move on. We woke up just before 5 o'clock. Card was in about 10 past 5, something like that. Done our checks, do a wash of my face quickly. Yeah, we've done our checks, we're good to go. So we've got to head towards Cirencester now. I'll find out what we're doing afterwards as well. So we've got to go Cirencester, then Thornbury, then Sherborne and Dorset. And then we've got to go back up to Portbury Docks in Bristol, get reloaded for tomorrow, which I believe is going somewhere in London, and then Tilbury Docks. So busy, need to get a move on. So yeah, I'm gonna get cracking. I'll see you when we're a little bit closer to Cirencester, when it's a bit lighter and we can show you the load and stuff, because I haven't showed you the load yet, have I? So anyway, lights are going off. I will see you in a bit. Bye bye. Okie dokie, we're in Cirencester. You can't really see me either. Let me just, I could turn that light on, that reading light coming down. Yeah, we're just in Cirencester now. And we're just about to turn up to our destination. Now, I forgot to say, I've woken up a bit since earlier as well. I forgot to say that when we get here, there's because I actually live not far from here, just around the corner really. And I actually come to this garden centre as a customer. I think there's a sign that says deliveries left, stone deliveries right, and I got two stone pallets and two normal pallets, so I don't know which way to go in. I'm thinking of just going in where the normal delivery yard is and then hope for the best. But I try and get some footage of the load itself. But this delivery is not on the back of the trailer, so they got to move some stuff. Oh, that's quite tight around that corner. I'm going to have to go on the curb to miss that. There we go. See, all other deliveries left. Plants, compost, timber, stoneware. Do you know what? While it's quiet, we're going to go right. While it's quiet, the car park's quiet. And then hopefully we can find somewhere down here, or someone down here that can take the delivery. I was going to go left, but we do have, like I said, two stone pallets. So we'll hope for the best. I don't know where to go though. This could be a bit annoying. Right, let's see if I can find someone. See you in a bit. Okay, here's the load. It's all strapped up. I've started undoing it on the other side. But all they need is that pallet and that pallet, which is in the middle. And then on the other side, they need two small pallets. There we go. I've already started undoing it. But this side, they just need those two pallets. So hopefully they can take those two out and put a couple on the back in its place. And then on the other side, well, I'm not sure what they're gonna do yet. Okay, we are offloaded. They've taken the pallets off. It is 7:30. I've decided not to move the other pallets forward because they're done up really tight. And there were gaps between the pallets anyway, a smaller gap. And they hadn't shifted a single bit. And I'm only going around the corner, so. They are still secured. It's not like they're not secured at all. And there's only like a metre gap, so it's fine. It's fine. You don't have to have them all bunched up. That's completely optional. Anyway, we've been told to go out a certain way. Turn those hazards off. We've got to turn right down here, and then turn left, and then left again, and come back out this way. But apparently, This is the easiest way of doing it, apparently. Da, da, da. Turn left here. Just mind that bollard. Excellent. That's a naughty left turn we've got to do, though. This car park gets rammed with cars. Like I said, that is a very naughty left turn. My trailers are going to go back out of them. And that cone's in the way. I'm going to miss that cone. No, I'm not going to be able to miss it without going over the curb. Let me just move that cone a sec.
But that was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, I've got to move that cone so I can take a wide swing around here. There we go, missed the curb. Now I've got to try and get out of this turn as well. Yeah, this car park's normally absolutely rammed with cars, as I said. It's my local garden centre, it's the closest one to me. And it does, it gets absolutely rammed. Christmas tree!
I'm listening.
I wasn't talking to you. Stop listening. Oh, that barrier's close. We've got to take it a bit wider.
I don't understand. Please say that again.
Shut up. Stupid sat nav. There we go. Missed it. It's all good. Right. Let's turn some lights off. Leave that one on for now. Seat that on. Happy days. Right. Now we've got to go Thornbury. So, yeah, we're going to Thornbury, get the remaining pallets off. Then we've got to go all the way down to Sherborne. So far, so good. But I did go down the right way. He asked me what I got on. I said, well, I got two pallets of stain and two pallets of normal pallets. He goes, yeah, we'll do it down here. So he said, well, it's quiet. We'll do it down here. So happy days. Oh, look at that, straight out. Could be a nightmare getting out of here during the day. Excellent! Right, let's get crack-a-lacking. We've done an hour and 40 minutes of driving already, and we are a good hour away from Thornbury. So, yeah. We've done nearly 3 hours driving before 9 o'clock. Happy days, happy days. Right, let's get cracking. See you in a bit. It should be a bit lighter when you see me next as well. See you in a bit. Okay, we are in Thornbury, just approaching our location. This is a nice bit of straight road, look. I do like a straight road like this. Being able to see quite far ahead is really nice. so we're heading to Thornbury. We'll be there literally less than a mile. They don't open till 9 o'clock, so, and it's only 8:30. So hopefully again the car parks are going to be quiet, because I think we've actually got to drive into the car park in this one. And according to the satellite view, if I go in and around, there's like a left turn or something. So we'll see if we can find that when we get in there. Now, the sat nav was taking me in on this next left coming up, but I don't know, it looked a little tight, so I'm going down to the next left, like 100 yards down the road. Yeah, it looks far too tight. It's taking me in that one there. That's not happening. Not a chance. Single track, no way. So I could tell it was too tight, so going in this next left. It actually says Dobby's here, look. Here we go. We are open 7 days a week. Just got to try and find... Oh, that's a bit rattly. Just got to try and find the delivery area. Also, this next one in Sherborne I got to do. It's not a Dobby's I'm going to, it's somewhere else. But I've been speaking to Kev T, who's around that area, and he said, have fun, Luke. He said, have your cameras rolling, Luke. So, I think that's going to be a bit tight. Right, is it this right here? I think it is. Entrance right. Yeah, we want to go in here. I think. Ooh, that is tight. A truck's already been down here, look. Bloody hell. That is tight. It actually says delivery's right. Oh man, that is so tight. See, according to Street View, deliveries were in there, but it does now say deliveries right. Okay, well, we're in, ish. Bloody hell, that looks way too tight. That looks far, far too tight. Surely this is not the way in. I don't know. We're going to straighten up anyway on this bit so people can get past us. Straighten up like this. We'll put the hazards on and we'll go and see if we can find someone. I reckon I can get around that corner, but I don't know where I go from there. That's all. So I'll go and find someone just to be safe. See you in a bit. Okay, so we are now here. Where we stopped is actually where they offload us, so that was a bit of good luck. I went in and found someone and they said, yeah, where you are, drive. So it's going to be the same as like it was earlier in Cirencester. They're going to obviously do one side first, and then I don't know if you can see, I'm going to have to move over for them to do the other side. But yeah, it's like, what time is it now? Hang on. It's 10 to 9 in the morning, so they haven't actually even opened yet. There's no one in the car park. I might need to reverse back where I am now, reverse into there, so then I can drive up that way, get a long swing round and come back down, because that corner might be a bit tight, that right turn I've got to take in a minute. But we'll see. But anyway, so that's the load. We've got 4 pallets this side that needs to come off, and I think there's like 6 on the other side. Let's go and have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 pallets to come off on this side. Like I said, we're going to have to move on over for them to take that side off because we're parked next to a curb. But yeah, no, I've been here now for about 10 minutes. It's all undone, all unstrapped, ready to go, but no one's come out yet, so I suspect it'd be another 10 minutes. As it's only 10 to 9, and when I went in, he said, oh, it'd probably be me, I'm the only forklifter in, so never mind. Right, hopefully this gets off, and then we can make our way to Sherborne. See you in a bit. Okay, that one's now done. It's nearly 9:30 now, so I've been here nearly an hour. I don't think he was the normal forklift driver, so he wasn't the fastest. I'm just turning my phone on airplane mode because I think that stops the signal interference. Right, let's try and get out of here now then. Like I said, it's quite a nasty left turn. Right turn. So I need to reverse and get as tight as I can to the left, in the hope I can get out. There are pedestrians on my right, but I can see them. There we go. Just wait for these pedestrians to go forward and then we'll proceed with our manoeuvre. See if we can get out. Mind the gate on the left, mind the gate on the right. Okay, more left. There we go, we're clear. Happy days. Cheers, mate. There we go. Hazards off. let's put this seatbelt on. Right, so I planned the route for Sherborne. It doesn't look too bad. So yeah, we head straight there now. Hopefully we can get there nice and quick. It's only 2 hours away, but I do need to call them on the way and just tell them I'm arriving, because it might be quite tight in there as well. A lot of these garden centres normally are quite tight. Right, I'm not going on any grass. I'll try and get out of this now without breaking anything. There's a car coming. You're going to have to go back, mate, because I can't. All good. Happy days! Yeah, where I'm going as well, the junction I've got to turn left at looks quite familiar, so I think, I'm sure I've been to Sherborne not too long ago. Not to this place I'm delivering to, but around that area. So I think the route, mostly, I've taken before. Another car, turn right. Yeah, you've got a lot of space to go down with me, though. Just clear both sides. There we go. Sometimes cars just go down the inside of you, not realising that your trailer's going to cut them up. So there was nowhere she could have gone anyway. She really should have just waited for me to come out. But because she went, which she, you know, is, I give way to her, so she, it's perfectly her right to go in, but then she's got nowhere to go anyway, and she can't see that from where she was. So, you know, what she done was not right. That's where it's time for me to go up there. Unsuitable for HGVs. My HGV sat-nav tried taking me up that unsuitable for HGV road. Bloody tom-tom. Right, let's go anyway. Let's get crack-a-lacking. I've got a van right up my bottom. Mate, you can smell what I had for last night, can't you? Woo! Right, see you in a bit. Okay. You join me in Penmill Trading Estate in Yeovil. We just had to stop for our break. And I delivered to a company behind me not too long ago, Duffield's. Yeah, we going past Yeovil. I was like, I swear I've been here before. I delivered round here. And then it comes to me, yeah, I delivered at Penmill Trading Estate, Duffield, and I knew I could park along here. So just had a break here. We've just had a 30 minute, so we're going to crack on now to our next destination. We're only about 15 minutes away from that Castle Gardens place. Now, I did phone them up when I was on my way, and I told them that I'd be there for about 11:30. But that was on the assumption I didn't stop for a break. But I would have ran out of driving time 5 minutes before I got there, so I thought it's best to have a break now. And we're good now, should be good for the rest of the day, hopefully. But yeah, I didn't want to run out of driving time once I got there, because, you know, you can't have a break on site whilst you're unloading, unless, of course, you finish unloading and then have a break. But then you need room to do that. And you also tend to need to hope that no other deliveries come in, otherwise you'll have to move. So, Penmill Trading Estate. Just thought I'd stop here and have a break straight away. So, we're good to go for the rest of the day. So, we're going to actually be there now for just about 12 o'clock. So, we'll get our foot down. Hopefully they take these pallets off nice and quick, about half 12 hopefully, 12:45 the latest. Because when we go to Bristol, we've got to be there before 4 o'clock. And I think it takes a good 2 hours to get there, so yeah, we wanna be leaving by 1 o'clock, definitely. So hopefully we will, because we haven't got that many pallets. I think there's like, I don't know exactly how many there are, five one side and six the other side, I think. So 11 tops, maybe 9. I think it's 9. Anyway, let's go. I'll see you in a bit. Yeah, I've definitely been down here before. This whole area rings a bell. I think I've done it when I was working with JK. Come down this area. Just gonna do my window up a little bit. can't remember where I delivered, or where I delivered to. I can't remember, but I've 100% been down here. So we're about a mile and a quarter of away. So it's just the build up. But I'm not entirely sure how tight these roads are going to get. Weight limit down there. So we're going straight on. Because I think we've got to come off this main road in a minute. Yeah, we're going to take a right-hand turn. Come off the main road. How tight does it get? That's the question. Hopefully not too tight. Although, yeah, Sherborne Castles, that's where we're going. There's no weight limit over there. Oh yeah, this is the bridge. Closed 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Oh, don't tell me you're closed down here. I need to turn left in a little while, so hopefully the road I need won't be closed, hopefully. Nice little train track. Sherborne Waste Management. No, not going down there. That bag was annoying me up there. Right, yeah, we're going left. We're going left. Gonna get on over. All clear. Okay, nearly there. It's pretty much just right in front of us behind those trees. Pretty much. And when I looked on the satellite view and Google Earth, it looks like the goods in entrance is in a different entrance to the car park. And the sign for saying goods in is also the way we're coming in from as well, so in other words you can't see it. So I have pinpointed it on my map, on my phone, before we set off. So hopefully we can get in the right entrance straight away. What do those signs say? It's not this left, but just in case. Maybe all good. Right, we're on a bare left here. The road goes around to the left anyway. That's the castle entrance, I believe. Sherborne Castle and Gardens. We do have a car behind me. Gonna start indicating. Couldn't see anything about deliveries there. That's the place. I think it's this right we need to take. The road does kind of insinuate it. Goods in. Yeah, there's a sign there saying goods in. Excellent. Hopefully we can spin round up here. Hopefully. Doesn't look like an awful lot of room. Yeah, I think we're spinning round here a little bit, looks a bit. Wants me to spin round this way. I don't understand where he wants me to park, actually. Both sides. Okay, mate, right. try not to wheel spin. Bow, bow, bow. Lovely doubly, he's going to be able to get both sides, that's good. Excellent. Right, let's get this off. I'll see you in a bit. See you in a bit. Done. Very quick as well. We got here at 12 o'clock and it's now 12:15. See years. Got to build up the level the suspension, build up that, and we also need to put our destination in, which is Bristol or Portbury Docks. My seat's going down. Bow, bow, bow. Excellente. I do apologise if you've been hearing weird noises again on the phone. What I normally just try to do is I put it in airplane mode, so it doesn't interfere so much. But the problem is I'm in so many different groups that the messages are always being sent, therefore my phone is always receiving data, which is a bit annoying. Anyway, let's go. See you later, mate. Oh, an hour and 45 to get there. A lot quicker than I thought it was going to be. Should be there for 2 o'clock, fingers crossed. I've got to go to the forest terminal, which I have been to before, but the difference is I've got to go get loaded with wood, because you're gonna need to wait, mate. I think I've got to go get loaded with wood because the two places I'm delivering to are timber places, but the last time I went to the forest thing is I collected slate. So anyway, let's try and get out of here. There is a car coming. Bam, bam, bam. Stay to the left. Just minding the wall on the left. There we go. Excellente. That was very quick. That was, like I said, 15 minutes to get that offloaded. So maybe 16 minutes. Very, very quick. Anyway, let's get going. Let's head to Bristol. Let's get loaded for tomorrow. If I'm loaded within the hour, I should be back in the yard for like 4:30. Good afternoon.
Hey, hello.
How are you doing? All right?
Hopefully. We'll see. Which one is first?
Can I have Tilbury Docks on the front, please? And then I'm going to Hoddesdon first. So I need Hoddesdon on the back. If that's
so
all right.
Only one, so we'll be on the... Alright, so headboard is this one.
Yeah. Load Tilbury first.
Yeah.
And then Hoddesdon on the back, on the top or whatever.
It's 18 and 1, so we have a 19 bucks. It won't be even, basically.
Yeah, that's fine, mate. Best you can.
Won't be even. Size are 8x4, so yeah. It will be like... At the back, you will have two on one side, or we can actually do two flat and this one
in the middle.
Because otherwise it won't be.
Yeah, do that. What I'll do then is on the back one, I'll strap the bottom layer, and then when you put the top one on, I'll strap that one as well.
Ah, okay.
We'll do that.
All right. Place yourself over there, just make him.
What? Where he is?
Yeah, somewhere next to him or. Back,
leave space for both sides. Yeah. All right, mate. I park behind him. I think that's what he said. Anyway, I was just about to start my GoPro and tell you how today's going so far. So we got here at 2 o'clock. It's now 2:30, and I thought I was going to be here a while because a lot of trucks were where I was just now. A lot of trucks, and I've gone in and got the paperwork, and they've told me to come here, and it's less busy, but there are still a lot of trucks. I don't quite know where we were saying to go, so I'm just going to park behind him. Not that you can see him because I don't have my forward facing GoPro on, but I'm going to park behind that truck there on my right. You should be able to see him a little bit. and hopefully get loaded. So we're getting loaded with wood. The first drop is only one lift, one pallet. That's quite funny. The rest of it's going to Tilbury Docks. So, but yeah. So we are going to park behind him. It's going to bunch back so people can get in between us. By people, I mean forklifts. And hopefully, where we are now, will do. Right. We got, I think he said we've got 19 lifts going on. There's 18 for the first one, which I'm going to assume is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know. I've got no idea. I guess they're really big or something. I don't know. We're finding out anyway. Right, let's go get this loaded. See you in a bit. Okay, we're nearly loaded. If I just show you quickly. So we basically two ratchets on each one. I know it's a bit windy. Two ratchets on each one. Just waiting for one more now to go on the back. And then we're done. Very noisy and windy here at the docks. But not a lot we can do about that. Just show you the other side as well. Exactly the same. So yeah, that's my load. That's going to go to Honington. Well, the one that's going to go on the top here in a minute is going to go to Honington. The rest of it is all going to Tilbury. All of that is going to Tilbury Docks. So yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. Do appreciate it. Hopefully you've had a good time. Remember to drive safe, stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.